Sixth section. Death from the law. No copyrights. We need to look at it together to be really dead from the law, so little in what it really is like in practical life. If your soul is deceased by the law, you are deceased from the things you once delighted in. You cannot be content with the cruel, baseless faith and the hope with which you once satisfied yourself. No, no, now you must be brought to the true, saving realization of Jesus Christ. Now it must be revealed to the soul, your inner, by the Spirit. Now you cannot be content with either or telling that it is such and such. No, you will now shout, Lord, still show me in the light of your Spirit by your word that Jesus, who was born in the days of Emperor Augustus, is the true Christ. Lord, let me see it in the light of your Spirit and by his effect, and let me not be satisfied without such faith as was affected by the revelation of his birth, crucifixion, death, blood, resurrection, ascension, intercession, and other personal return, so that true faith in all that may fill my soul with your comfort and your holiness. But how scared are you, basically, not to lose the faith and the hope of the living God that you have gained through such revelations of Jesus? The soul, inside you, knows that if you do not have it, you will not be able to endure neither in death, life, nor before the face of God in his judgment. Therefore, you say, Lord, whatever other poor souls are pleased with, let me have what can help me withstand the cunning devil who can help me to suck true, genuine, soul-healing comfort from Jesus Christ through your promises, by the power and power of your Spirit. Never let me get stones for bread, always give me the real thing. You actually have to be as thirsty as a dry sponge that, when lying down, sucks and sucks, so it is important that you are not wet already, have filled yourself with other things before you come to Jesus and get life. Do not suck any water into it. Now that your soul, you who do not want to be deceived, has such revelation of God's love through a bleeding, dying, resurrection, and improving Jesus, there is no reason for you to be afraid of losing the Lord Jesus. But the temptation of your soul is blah. False prophets' teachings, hypocrites, deceivers that you've experienced so much in your past life, therefore, you fear in between that it should not be right, not come from God. Can't the devil give such comfort too? Says the soul, can he not assume the form of an angel of light, 2 Cor 11:14? Because now your soul will stand on a secure ground. It cries out, Lord, show me your salvation, and this not once or twice, but, Lord, let my heart always experiences your presence, today, tomorrow, and every day. Because when you are taken out of the covenant of works and put into the covenant of grace, put with Jesus Christ in heaven, and you now have complete free access into the holiest, then you cannot, unless you are in an overwhelming great temptation, being content without the presence of God, learning, comforting, strengthening, and helping you grow in the things that belong to the Lord Jesus Christ, you know if God in any way evades his presence, which you do well in between may feel for a short time, then you can be sure that the devil is near, and will come with his temptations and try every way to get you into sin and slavery. Also man's own rotten nature agrees, and makes common cause with the evil one, and is willing to join with him in crashing the soul into misfortune. It brings the soul to seriously and persistently sigh for more of God's empowering, enduring comforting, and teaching closeness. Do you know God's nearness as a reality? Where do you really hear and see God in Jesus? Or is most only theory without practice?